Welcome to Rajendra Tandon videos. We continue with Bhramar Geet, a collection of verses written by Surdas, who was a 16th century poet, a devotional poet and singer. He was known for his lyrics written in praise of Krishna. His lyrics are written in Braj Bhasha, one of the two literary dialects of that time. Surdas was a part of the Bhakti movement spreading across the Indian subcontinent. This movement represented spiritual empowerment of the masses. Some other poets of this movement include Kabir, Tulsidas and Mirabai. The genesis of Bhramar Geet poems can be traced to Srimad Bhagavat Puran. According to the narration in the Puran, the inhabitants of Braj could not reconcile with the loss of Krishna to Mathura. Krishna, who was born in a prison cell in Mathura, had been transported to be brought up in Gokul by Nand and Yashoda as their own child. As he grew up, he fascinated everybody around with his childhood pranks like stealing butter, breaking the milk pots. On growing up further, he became a favorite of the cowmaids of Gokul, who loved to dance with him, to listen to his music, and mentally make love to him. Later, Krishna went to Mathura to kill his maternal uncle Kansa, who was the king and who had imprisoned his parents as well as his own father, Ugrasen. As stated above, the gopis of Mathura could not reconcile with the loss of Krishna. The gopis of Gokul could not reconcile to the loss of Krishna to Mathura. Knowing this, Krishna sent Uddhav, a childhood friend, to Braj, where Uddhav explained the divinity of Krishna to Nand and Yashoda. He told them that Krishna was formless, unborn, without a beginning and an end, and omnipresent. He advised them to look for that Krishna rather than the child they had brought up. At this stage, the gopis who had assembled by this time took Uddhav aside and probed him to learn as much as they could about their beloved Krishna. They repeatedly chanted Krishna's name. Meanwhile, a black bee droned into this assembly. The gopis taunted Uddhav through the medium of the bee. These verses are therefore named Bhramar Geet. Each verse in Bhramar Geet has got a new image, a new simile referring to Krishna. In the verse under consideration today, the gopis say that Krishna's image is lodged in their heart in such a manner that it cannot be taken out. उर्मे माखन चोर गड़े अब कैसे हूं निकसत नहीं उधो तिरछी हुए जू अड़े. He's standing in a dancing pose, limbs this way, that way, and those limbs are stuck in their heart. जदपि अहीर जसोदा नंदन तदपि न जात छड़े महा बने जदु वंश महाकुल हम ही न लगत पड़े. He might have been just a cowboy here, son of our chief, and having moved to Mathura, he may have become a prince, but it does not matter to us, for in our heart of hearts, he is still one of us. को वसुदेव वो देव की है को ना जाने और बुझे. We do not know about Vasudev and Devaki. You say they are his parents. We are ignorant of them. For us, he is the son of Nand and Jasoda, brought up in Gokul and loved by us. We played with him, we danced with him, we loved him, we kissed him, we caressed him. Sur Shyam Sundar Binu Dekhu Aur Na Koi Sujhe. We can't think of anybody else outside Krishna, beyond Krishna. We love him so immensely. The beauty of the image is that of a dancing Krishna stuck in the hearts of the gopis, as if it is a physical statue stuck there. कृष्ण के त्रिभंगी रूप का ध्यान हृदय से ना निकलने का कारण उद्धव को बताते हुए गोपियां कहती हैं, हमारे हृदय में माखन चोर कृष्ण का त्रिभंगी रूप ऐसा गट गया है, ऐसा चुभ गया है कि निकल नहीं सकता. आप कहते हो वे यशोदा के पुत्र हैं और अहीर हैं, हमारे मन में उनके लिए प्रेम उसी का है, मथुरा में गए राजकुमार का नहीं. भले ही वे यदुवंश के राजा बन गए हों, हम नहीं जानते वसुदेव कौन है. देवकी कौन है, कंस कौन था, हमें तो कृष्ण केवल यशोदा नंदन के ही रूप में दिखते हैं. को वसुदेव देव की है को ना जाने और बुझे. सूर श्याम सुंदर बिनु देखो और ना कोई सूझे. हम नहीं सोच सकते किसी और के बारे में भी, हमें तो वही कृष्ण नजर आता है जो हमारे साथ खेलता था. हम आपके ज्ञान और निर्गुण ब्रह्म की उपासना के बारे में कुछ नहीं सुनना चाहते. भ्रमर गीत इज ए फेबुलस कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ विरह, ग्रीफ ऑफ सेपरेशन, ज्ञान एंड भक्ति. इट इज ए कंपोजिशन इन द फेस ऑफ विच ज्ञान टेक्स ए बैक सीट. Here the entire logic of yoga accepts defeat. All that remains is absolute devotion, bhakti and bhakti alone. Surdas as a poet primarily delves in vatsalya, shringar and shantarasa. With his burning intelligence and imagination, he has painted the childhood of Krishna in luminous colors. His descriptions are beautiful, alive, and psychologically enriching. His Krishna is an embodiment of love and sweetness. Surdas combined bhakti and shringar to describe union and separation with an intensity seldom achieved elsewhere. His verses not only reach a pinnacle of emotional content, but are also rated high for a poet's craft. His language is simple, expression spontaneous, and words full of learning. He is rich in imaginative similes and metaphors. He is one of the greats of Hindi poetry. He not only enriched literature with emotion and linguistic excellence, but also pioneered a unique tradition in Krishna Kavya. I stop here today and I meet you again with another video tomorrow. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you for visiting this site.